Well, it's finals time here in the Seva Arena in Krasnoyarsk at the Winter Universiade of 2019, the first Winter Games in Russia. So there is confirmation of the lineup for the women's 1500 meter B final here at the 29th edition of the Winter Universiade. The ladies come to the line waiting for our starter judge.
Go to the start. Ready.
So a smooth and steady start to the ladies 1500 meter B final here at the short track speed skating arena. 13 and a half laps of the track. This for positions 7 to 12 at the Krasnoyarsk Games 2019. Very steady pace here. Nicole Botta Gomez from Italy just leading the way here, but very leisurely pace. Chinese athlete coming around the outside wearing the number 3 is Ai Li Zhu. 22 years old. It looks like the Japanese athletes are going to make a break here. Number 15 coming around the outside, Tanaka, the 22-year-old. That's Yamura and Tanaka sandwiching Gon. In fact, Gon has just taken the lead. Pace starting to climb. Gong Li, the youngest in the field, and it's her teammate now, Zhu Aili. She's pulled out the front and a massive tumble. Botta Gomez down and the whistle has been blown. This B final will be abandoned and restarted. See, their coaches check the skates are fine. I believe it was Emma van Zwielen who also took a tumble in that grouping. Women's B final restarted here. And it looks like all six competitors will line up. So underway for the ladies 1500 meter B final. Restarted because of a tumble by the Dutch athlete Van Zwielen, who took out a couple of her competitors. She's from Leiden, the Dutch athlete. Has a PB of 2:27.854. Took out Botta Gomez, who was leading the way. Decided to stay out front and stay away from trouble as the two Japanese athletes put the power down. And the Dutch athlete has now slipped up into second place. She too wants to stay out of the way of any possible clashes. Zhu coming into play as Botta Gomez goes around the outside. The Italian dropping back already, Bolzano, and we've lost. We've lost Van Zwielen again. She's taken a tumble this time and didn't take anyone else out. Meanwhile, up front, it's Gong Li of China. She's just been overtaken by Zhu Aili. Zhu Aili out front now, pushing the accelerator. Botta Gomez drifts into second and Gong is in third. The two Japanese athletes trailing Yamamura ahead of Tanaka at the back of the field. Van Zwielen just skating around Probably more to get the lactic out of her legs more than anything else. Zhu is up front. Bota Gomez just trailing behind. Japanese athlete having a go. Miwako Yamura nearly taking out Gong in third place. Two laps to go. Zhu leading the way from Bota Gomez. Zhu, the Chinese athlete, puts the pedal down a bit more. Bota Gomez tries to stay with her. Gong is just behind. Zhu, Chinese Skating Union member. She trains with the national team. She's out front in the ladies 1500 B final. The bell's gone. She's going to take the B final here at Krasnoyarsk 2019. Timed her sprint to perfection. Zhu Aili of China takes the B final from Nicole Bota Gomez of Italy. She stayed the course, the Italian, but just couldn't apply any pressure. The second Chinese athlete, Gong Li, took third place. Well, a restarted B final there, won by the Chinese athlete, Zhu Aili. From Nicole Bota Gomez, you see the tumble, the second tumble from the Dutch athlete in that restarted B final. But there is Zhu Aili coming around the final bend to take the B final from Nicole Bota Gomez and Gong Li. So Efremenkova is wearing bib number, helmet number 34. Zakharova is wearing 39. And Prosvinova, 37. Three Russians in the ladies' A final. The ladies' 1500 meters short track speed skating final is underway. Three Russians in the lineup here in Krasnoyarsk. Well, it's Yuna Koyoki who's taken the lead here in the early stages. Again, the pace is a settled one. Of the three Russians, it's Sofia Prosvinova who's pushed out to the front first. Kima Lang just settled in to fourth place. But it's Zakharova who's pulled out as well. Now Kima Lang, well, the two Koreans pushing hard. Prosvinova trying to do the hard work out front. But Park Ji-yun, promoted from the semi-finals, is through. Kima Lang, studying physical education at Korea National Sports University, the two-time Olympic gold medalist in the 3000 relay in Sochi and Pyeongchang. But it's a teammate at the moment who's pressing the buttons. Kim Ah Lang trying to press hard. She's out front. Sofia Prosvinova gets the crowd going, but the two Koreans are poised. Aurélie Monvoisin in fourth. Speed has cracked up a notch here. Kim Ah Lang presses the go button, but so does Monvoisin. And now Prosvinova in second place, trailing Kim Ah Lang. Two laps to go. They'll get the bell. They come round. Here we go. Kim Ah Lang pushing hard. Sofia Prosvinova did all the hard work. There is the bell. Kim Ah Lang, has she got the legs? Oh, Prosvinova's training right back, but pushing hard is Efremenkova. And Kim Ah Lang takes it on the line. She is the champion of Krasnoyarsk 2019 in the ladies' 1500 meters. She pressed the go button at just the right time. And she pushed all the way through, wearing the number 22, Kim Ah Lang from Korea, 23 years old, is the champion. Of course, the judges will review the results as we look back. There's Sofia Kozvirinova. She did so much hard work, but just ran out of legs. Well, there's a tap there from her teammate. Sakharova nearly took her teammate out. There she is up front, but Kim Ah Lang just slipping up the inside, taking the lead at the perfect time for her, and she had the legs to carry on. A big tussle there between Park Ji-yun and Prosvirinova, and Aurélie Wongvoisin, well, she was quiet and just kept with Kim Ah Lang at the end to take second place. And what a smile there, a double. And there it is, we have got confirmation in the ground here. Kim Ah Lang is the champion of the ladies 1500 meters. Aurélie Wongvoisin of France in second place, and Ekaterina Evrenkova of Russia gets a bronze medal here in Krasnoyarsk. There is confirmation of our starters here. Been a lively field in the men's competition here with a FISU record today already. So the men's 1500 meters B final is underway, and looking like no records are going to be set here in the B final. A very, very leisurely start. So Sergei Milovanov takes the lead. Dan Iwasa sitting in second, but the pace is very, very slow as things stand. They just slowly build this one up. Will explode, that's for sure. And if today's form is anything to go by, Lim Yongjin is the one to look out for. He makes a break with 3/4 laps to go. The Koreans have shown they've got the legs to finish these ones off if they can get up the front. Milovanov just giving up the lead to Mircea Zakshibaev of Kazakhstan. But look at that. Just like that, the Korean goes up front. Lim Yongjun, now the man setting the pace. Dan Iwasa goes around the outside. Riku Koyama sitting in third, and the two Japanese athletes, well, they were sandwiching Lim, but just like that, Jong Yujin puts on a little spurt, takes the lead, and it's only Dan Iwasa who's really sticking with him. Just staying in contention. Zhong hasn't got the legs. 3 to go. He presses the go button even harder. He's pushing hard. That gets a reaction from Lim Yongjun. And look at him go. The Korean, with 2 laps to go, has said, that's not fast. This is fast. He's pressed the button. He's going to get the bell. Lim Yongjun could run away with this. He could win this by 8-9 meters. He is ahead. Who's going to get second? It looks like Koyama took second on the line. We wait for confirmation on that one. At the moment, it looks like it was Koyama who took second. But Lim Yong Jin, he just tucked away in third when it looked like Zhong was going to be able to hold on. Lim said, okay, enough's enough, and took to the front. A brilliant performance from the young Korean. Absolutely superb. Just pressed the button at the right time. And then it was like he had rockets on his skates. Did Zhong hold on? Or was it the Japanese athlete, Dan Uwasa? We wait for confirmation. At the moment, for me, well, Lim clearly miles ahead. Riku Koyama took the second place. Oh, and it was Zhong in the end. On the video, you can see that clearly held on to third spot here in the men's B final. But Lim Yong Jin, absolutely brilliant here. The 22-year-old put on a real show of speed in the last couple of laps and has taken the men's B final. Here is the lineup for the men's A final in the 1500 meters. Quiet called in the crowd here for the start of the men's A final.
Go to the start.
Start of the final. It's not the speed that we see at the end, but it's certainly a touch faster than the B final. And it's Quentin Fekok of France leading the way at the moment in these early stages from Keiichi Shigehiro of Japan. Fekok, remember, he broke his tibia in 2011 from Le Havre. He's just been swallowed up by the two Koreans, Park, G1. Just sitting at the back there now. So it's Hong Kyung-hwan pulling out from the front, but here comes Kashgali. He has shown some form, but look at that. Park G1 just increased the speed by a tiny bit and almost leisurely cruised around the outside to take the lead. He's now leading from Ankai, but his Korean teammate says, I'm going to come around the outside. And Shigehiro says, okay, you're going to up the pace. I'm going to come with you. In fact, I'm going to take the lead. Shigehiro leading now from Hong and Park. Kashgali sitting in fourth, but Ann now trying to press the button on the outside. He does. He goes wild. Shigehiro was leading for a while from Tokyo. Sagamihira Skating Club. But it's Anki going through the front, and just like that, Park G1 says, okay, you think that's fast? Try this. Fekok coming around the outside. He wants to play in this final here, but the two Koreans leading from the Chinese athlete, Park leading Hong, and it's Hong who's pressing the buttons now. Park trying to hold the line, defend, and stop his teammate coming around the outside. But now Hong switches to the inside. The bell's gone. The two Koreans are down. The two Koreans are down and out. And, well, look at that. An Kai from China has taken gold. What an amazing end there to Nick. Kashgali takes silver. A brilliant, brilliant finish to the race. The two Koreans absolutely going toe-to-toe and in the end just got too close to each other to the benefit of that young man there. An Kai, 23 years old from Qingdao, is the champion of Krasnoyarsk 2019. Well, there's sure to be an internal inquiry there. Hong, well, he looked like he was going faster than his teammate. He certainly was trying to get round the outside. But look at Anki pushing down the button, absolutely going for it early doors. There was a big switch around in this one, but when the two Koreans went for it, the speed was quite phenomenal. And just look, in the end, it was actually Park Ji-won who took out his teammate. He didn't expect Hong Kyung-hwan to slip up the inside and just cut across the back of his skates. And there you go, Ankai of China absolutely blitzed the field. Went storming in and took gold here in Russia. Well, Ankai couldn't have asked for a luckier break. I'm sure he felt he was here to contend for medals, but I'm not sure he thought he'd beat both of the Koreans. But Park Ji-won did not expect Hong Kyung-hwan to slip up the inside of him on the final lap. And as he turned the final corner, cut across the back of his opponent and his teammate, and they both eliminated themselves from the A final here in the men's 1500 meters. Well, there is confirmation. In fact, Kashgali got penalized, and it's Keiichi Shigehiro who moves up into the bronze medal position, with Hong Kyung-hwan finishing off in fourth place. But the speed was nothing like it was early on. There are our medalists in the women's 1500 meters. Kim Alang taking gold from Aurélie Noël Monvoisin and Russia's very own Ekaterina Evremenkova. Well, that's it from the Severina from session one in the short track speed skating arena. The 1500 meters is done in both the men's and women's. Kim Alang taking gold for Korea in the women's event, and Ankai from China taking gold in the men's.